You know, I haven't been very honest with you guys. You see, there's something I've kept close to my chest for a long time, and I feel that, well, I should share with you guys. Hey, I'm a programmer. And welcome to a brand new series that was inspired by a few new joinees of my Discord server. As they are beginners to programming and game development, we were discussing the How It's Developed series and found that much of the terminology and how things flow together really didn't make too much sense for them.
Nothing you say makes sense. Bloody idiot.
So, this series will be learning the fundamentals of the C# programming language, but with a slight twist. Not only will we be doing a console project, but we will also be using Unity and CryEngine to showcase as well. Without further ado, let's sit back, relax, and get started with learning the fundamentals of the C# programming language. It is best to always start from the very beginning, and by that, I mean the dreaded how to install the software we will be using. If you already have this software installed, then wait until episode 2, where we will be beginning the journey with writing some actual code. Let's get started with first installing CryEngine, Unity, and Visual Studio. I should note right away that this will be done on Windows, as CryEngine does not work on macOS or Linux. To install Visual Studio, there are a few ways to go about it. Unity will install Visual Studio Community Edition 2017 for you, or you can go to the official Microsoft website to download the installer file from there. To download Visual Studio, go to visualstudio.com and highlight Download for Windows for the Visual Studio IDE section. This will open up three options: 2017 Community, Professional 2017, and Enterprise 2017. Community 2017 is fully featured and free, so I'd suggest that option. The Visual Studio 2017 Community Edition download size is 1,153 kilobytes, or 1.12 megabytes in size. To download CryEngine, go to CryEngine.com and select Get CryEngine. In order to download, you have to sign up with the username, your email, and a password created, plus do the reCAPTCHA verification check. After that, you can download the launcher, which is an 80 megabyte download size. To download Unity, go to unity3d.com and select towards the top right of the webpage, Get Unity. You have three options: Personal, Plus, and Pro. Because I'm cheap, I'll select Personal Edition. This will take you to the Accept Terms page. Click on the box to accept the terms, and that will enable the link to download the installer. Click on the box that says Download Installer, and Unity will begin to download, which has a file size of 777 kilobytes. Now that we have the installer files of all three items that we will be using for this series, we can move on to installing them. I will go with the order of Visual Studio, Unity, and finally CryEngine. The reason for this order is because I am going from the longest to shortest install times. Go ahead and click on the installer file for Visual Studio and go through the steps to install Visual Studio 2017 Community Edition. For me, it will go quickly because I already have it installed. For you, it will take a while. After that, the Visual Studio installer will be on the screen. You will need to click Modify to add languages to Visual Studio. If it is not on screen, click on the Start menu and look for Visual Studio Installer. Make sure you have .NET Desktop Development selected and Game Development with C++. Although I have Game Development with Unity checked, you should not. This will happen when we install Unity later on. Once Visual Studio has fully downloaded these components, we can close the Visual Studio installer. Now we can select to install Unity by clicking on the installer file. Follow the basic prompts, and when you get to choose components, select Unity 2017 Editor, Mono Developed / Debugger, Documentation, Standard Assets, Android Build Support, Vuforia, and WebGL build support, and then click Next. Specify where you want the engine to be installed, and go ahead and install the engine. Once the engine is fully installed, we can launch it and verify that it works. Go ahead and close Unity for now. The last item to install is CryEngine. Click on Next and choose the install location of the launcher. This won't take long at all to install, but the engine itself will take a bit of time and setup. Once it finishes installing, click on the launcher and load it up. Once it has loaded, you will have to log in with your username and password. From there, click on New Project and it will take you to install the engine version you want. Select 5.5 Preview and it will begin to install along with the verification box that you should click Yes to. It shouldn't take too much time as it is less than 4 gigabytes in size. There is one last bit of setup to complete before we are ready to begin learning C#. Navigate to the folder where you installed CryEngine. Click on CryEngine Launcher, Crytek, CryEngine 5.5, Tools, and Visual Studio Extensions. Select the CryEngine Debugger VSIX file and install the extension to Visual Studio. For me, again there because it is already installed. Now, we are just about ready to begin our adventure in learning C# using a console project, CryEngine, and Unity. The last bit of setup we are going to do is create a project for Unity, CryEngine, and the Windows console app. We have now created our projects, and with that, stay tuned in for the next episode where we learn about some of the primitive types and some of the ways that we can use them. This has been Jessica, the Rising Phoenix Dev, and remember, by three methods we may learn wisdom. First, by reflection, which is noblest. Second, by imitation, which is easiest. And third, by experience, which is the bitterest.